Man,
come over here and check out stuff.
So first, I gotta ask you: did you have a Spar Spence? Or did you have a Spar Crawford?
I never Spar Spence or Crawford.
All right, break down.
I was trying to. No, I was. Well, actually, I didn't never get a chance to. Break it down. Okay, so it's hard for me to say, but I think that before I was thinking more of Spence to be more of the edge because I thought that he was a better. Maybe a better boxer can move around and you know, maybe get the way and outpoint Crawford. Now I see, you know, Spitz been through some car accidents, stuff like that. I know about injuries, how it affects you, because I've been injured, you know, hernia, groin, Achilles, you know, and all that stuff, so it plays a big part. And when you're not 100%, when you're going up against another opponent that's just as good as you, and you're not 100%, I mean, it's very hard to beat them. So I think that Crawford, you know, he's probably more 100%, and he's a game fighter. He's willing to win. So I'm leaning more towards Crawford because of that. Not saying that Earl Spence won't be able to beat him. I think it could be a 50-50 fight, but I just think that with all things that happened to Earl Spence, you know, the car accidents like that takes a big toll. And there might be a hard hill to climb up in that fight. So we'll see what happens. Anything can happen. I don't know. It's been a long time. It's been like a year or 2 years.
And he fought Ugas and beat him off of Retina, and he also beat Danny.
But they're not James Crawford, though. So is that the same person? He did beat Ugas, and he did beat the other, but they're not. They're both like the top and the best.
Okay, by the way, Shane, did Michael Buffer ever introduce you?
Yes, all
Mike,
the time.
Can you jump in really
all
quick?
All the time.
Come on, Mike. So let me ask both you guys really quick.
Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.